to speak with other tongues is not to resign the control of one's mind or to indulge your emotions to a point of extraction. Loved one, let me tell you, the exercise of speaking in other tongues does involve a conscious choice to just allow God's assistance to transcend our own linguistic limits. But it does not surrender to any order of a mystical or trance-like trip beyond oneself, no.
Welcome to Your Place of Grace with Evangelist Anthony Sluzes. We're taking the message of salvation, Holy Spirit renewal, and healing through the finished work of Christ to the world by every available means. If you'd like more information about Your Place of Grace Ministries and our resources, visit yourplaceofgrace.com.
Hi, everybody. I welcome you back once again to Your Place of Grace. Today we continue and actually we conclude our short two-part series on your supernatural prayer language. We're talking about inviting the Lord to fill you with the Holy Spirit. Now, I know that there has been so much stuff and so much fear, and ignorance breeds fear. I'm not saying people are being dumb, but ignorance, meaning not understanding, not knowing, not being read up on the subject. And granted, there have been a lot of abuses with spiritual gifts in churches over the years. I know that. But you know what? I'm not going to stop speaking in other tongues. I'm not going to stop praying in other tongues. I'm not going to stop that just because there have been abuses. Hey, there have been abuses with automobiles, but I ain't walking across the country. I'm going to drive. But just do it sensibly. Do it lovingly. And I want to share a personal testimony here. Actually, years and years ago, when I was baptized in the Holy Spirit, I came from a Catholic background. I didn't understand this Pentecostal stuff or this charismatic thing. But when I received the fullness of the Holy Spirit, I just overflowed with love toward Jesus. Because, see, Jesus is the baptizer in the Holy Spirit. And it just flowed from me. And I continue to pray in other tongues in my spiritual prayer language every day to this very day. And it empowers you. It builds up your spirit, man, kind of like a spiritual Arnold Schwarzenegger, for lack of a better comparison. Early on, my wife, who had no religious background whatsoever, she got saved shortly after I did. She gave her heart to Christ. And she's not an emotional person. She's not extremely demonstrative. And she just had a little bit of an issue with this baptism in the Holy Spirit and speaking in other tongues and the gifts of the Spirit. But she wanted more of Jesus. And after all, that's what we're talking about, wanting more and more of Jesus. Because he is the baptizer in the Holy Spirit. So there was one particular night when my wife and I were fast asleep, and we had two little children at that time. Our kids were little. And my wife had a dream that she was actually sitting up in the center of the bed praying for our little children at that time. And she was crying out to God. She was praising him, worshiping, and yet interceding for our kids. When she could find no more words in English to express, and yet it was the love for God was just welling up within her, and the love for our children. And in this dream, she began to cry out to God, speaking in a heavenly prayer language, speaking in other tongues. Lo and behold, she wakes up from this dream, sitting in the center of in the middle of our bed, praying in the Holy Spirit, in other tongues, for our children and for me. That's how my wife was baptized in the Holy Spirit. It can happen anywhere, at any time. But you must say yes to the experience. You must say yes to the Holy Spirit. You must say yes to more of Jesus in your heart and life. And it'll happen. More and more people are discovering the normalcy as opposed to the negativity of speaking with tongues. It's happening in every denomination across the board. And so it is that I want to invite anyone to join me right now in considering the beauty of speaking in tongues, the beauty of being baptized in the Holy Spirit. It's neither to mumblings of gibberish or crazy flights of fancy that I invite you now to consider this prayerfully. The Bible's description of speaking in tongues is not revulsive. When the Bible speaks on the subject and everything is sorted out and integrated in a way that shows a whole rather than a partial picture, the beauty of praying and speaking in other tongues comes into focus. You see it clearly. You begin to see things clearly in your heart. And when you do, when you pull away all the denominational gobbledygook and just believe the Bible, just believe the Bible, then you'll experience the complete desirability of such a resource in prayer for you. It's for everybody who believes in Jesus. Now, to set the frame for such a picture, let me make four things very clear right now from the outset. First of all, speaking with tongues is neither unbiblical or outdated. Never have the majority of Christian theologians or expositors argued against the timeless availability of this form of prayer, speaking in tongues. But while a diminishing number of sincere but stubborn souls just stoutly refuse this proposition, nothing in the New Testament scriptures restricts or confines speaking with tongues to being only a first century phenomenon. Only some strained, laborious, interpretative schemes can impose a notion like this onto the text of scripture. The idea of outdated, or it's no longer for us today, it was only for the early church. This kind of stuff cannot be found in God's word. It is for today. Jesus is for today. He is the baptizer in the Holy Spirit. And when we're seeking the baptism in the Spirit, we're seeking more of Jesus. Secondly, speaking with tongues is not some transcendental experience. No, the ways of God in dealing with his redeemed children may be supernatural in the source of his operations, but they're not weird. They're not weird in their ways of working. To speak with other tongues is not to resign the control of one's mind or to indulge your emotions to a point of extraction. Loved one, let me tell you, the exercise of speaking in other tongues does involve a conscious choice to just allow God's assistance to transcend our own linguistic limits. But it does not surrender to any order of a mystical or trance-like trip beyond oneself. No, no. Thirdly, speaking with other tongues or praying in tongues is not some status symbol. Boy, one of the most ugly things concerning speaking in other tongues is that the sole orientation may have to the subject of tongues is its presentation as a qualifier. It's you're a member of the club now. It verifies that you're this or that. Wait a minute. Let me tell you, if devoted believers in Christ hear this kind of thing, and if they have not spoken with tongues as of yet, they sometimes feel that they're being cast in a role of second-class citizen as slightly sub-Christian, only on the grounds of they're not having yet spoken in tongues. And I'm telling you, unsurprisingly, these people flee the subject, since the very proposition smacks of cultishness and it violates love. It violates the scripture. Fourthly, speaking with tongues is not proposed as a substitute for spiritual growth. As beautiful as an ongoing experience in the use of speaking in tongues can be at prayer, and as perfectly scriptural and desirable as it can be demonstrated to be by itself, speaking with tongues holds no peculiar merit. Let me tell you, growth in the Christian life requires feeding on God's Word, walking in the disciplines of His Son, and fellowshipping with His family, the church. But just as speaking a nation's language doesn't necessarily mean that you're a citizen of that country or that you live according to its laws, so someone's appearing to speak with tongues does not by itself guarantee that the speaker has been born into God's kingdom or is living in obedience to God's word. I love praying in other tongues. I love singing and worshiping the Lord in my spiritual prayer language. And I'm telling you, it has helped me grow. It has helped me grow in Christ and in the love for Him, in the love for His Word. It has empowered me to be a witness, to be Jesus' witness on this earth. And I thank God that I am filled with the Holy Spirit and that I do speak and pray with other tongues as the Holy Spirit gives me utterance. It has brought me nearer and nearer to the heart of God. Now I want to pray for you and with you right now. And I pray that something in you is saying, yes, Lord Jesus, I want more of you. Please fill me, baptize me with your Holy Spirit. Pray this prayer with me right now, wherever you are. If you're in a car, pull over and pray this with me right now. Dear Lord Jesus, oh Lord, I thank you and I praise you for your great love and faithfulness to me. My heart is filled with joy whenever I think of the great gift of salvation you have so freely given to me at the cross. And I humbly glorify you, Lord Jesus, for you have forgiven me of all my sins and brought me to the Father. Now I come in obedience to your call. I want to receive the fullness of your Holy Spirit. Jesus, I do not come because I'm worthy of myself, but because you have invited me to come, because you have washed me from my sins. I thank you that you have made the vessel of my life a worthy one to be filled with the Holy Spirit of the living God. I want to be overflowed with your life, Jesus, with your love and your power. I want to show forth your grace, your words, your goodness, and your gifts to everyone I can. And so, with simple, childlike faith, I ask you, Lord, to fill me now with the Holy Spirit. I open all of myself to you, and I lift my voice in praise to you, Lord. I welcome your might and your miracles to be manifested in me for your glory and unto your praise. Loved one, don't say amen yet, but just continue to worship him. Praise him. Love on Jesus. And simply allow the Holy Spirit to help you do so. Open your mouth right now. If you sense words, maybe a phrase, some syllables deep, deep within your spirit as you worship Jesus, speak them out right now. If they're not English, speak them out right now. That's the Holy Spirit of the living God giving you the utterance to pray in tongues. Worship Jesus. Worship the Lord right now. Lord Jesus, I praise you. I worship and adore you. I thank you for what you did for me at Calvary's cross. I thank you that you have washed away my iniquities and cleansed me from my sins. I thank you that I am a citizen of heaven and that I am your child, your servant here on earth. Use me, Jesus, as I love on you and praise you, Lord. Use me to reach and touch other people. Give me the power of your Spirit in order to do so. Begin to worship him. Open your heart and just worship him in other tongues as the Holy Spirit gives you the syllables, gives you the words. Kere te la lama shatanara, rama himera kutota yetisi, tisanaga yotona kata. Just like that. Worship Jesus. Praise God. Thank you for listening today. Glorify Jesus right now. Just keep on glorifying and praise him. Glorify Jesus and leave the rest to the Holy Spirit. Amen? Amen. Thank you for listening. Continue to worship. Praise him in English, in your native tongue, and in the tongues that the Holy Spirit gives you. Again, the Holy Spirit will give you syllables, words, maybe a phrase or sentences deep in your belly, in your spirit, man. Speak those out. Speak them. By faith. Do it now. I love you. I love you, my brother, my sister. Until we meet again, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you. May the Lord be gracious unto you and always have a smiling countenance toward you. And may he give you peace, protection, prosperity, joy unspeakable and full of glory, laughter and unconditional love within your marriages, families, and homes. And may he grant you great, great favor everywhere you step foot, all the days of your long, long life. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.
Thank you so much for listening to Your Place of Grace with Anthony Sluzes. We trust the podcast was a blessing to you. If you'd like more information about our ministry, resources, testimonials, and to schedule Anthony to speak at your event, go to yourplaceofgrace.com.